Hi folks, it's Switchback. I'd like to go over the clothing that I wore on my snowshoeing trip and kind of go over what worked for me, what didn't work for me. And I'm gonna have links to everything in the description as best I can. Everything in this video is something that I purchased myself. None of this was given to me or sponsored or anything like that. You probably already know that layering is really important, especially in the winter time, and you want to wick away any possible sweat before it can cool you down. For the trek in, I wore a synthetic REI base layer shirt with my REI Sahara sun hoodie over it. You've probably seen me in this sun hoodie. I love them so much. I have 5 of them now. I really enjoy these shirts. The base was one that I just got. So far, so good. I'm happy with it. I actually got it. It was one of the used gear items. So never forget those little racks. You can find some good stuff there. I wore my usual prana pants. Again, you've seen me wear these a zillion times probably, and they don't make the exact same ones anymore, so I'll link to the current ones, but I can't really speak to how they've changed. I tried out some Darn Tough boot socks, and I have other Darn Tough socks that I've really liked so far. I had switched over from Balega for running and trail running, trail running, hiking, etc., and Mountain Goat has been wearing these Darn Tough boot socks for a while for work, and she really likes them, so I decided to get a pair. I'm really happy with them. They were really cushy, nice and tall for my snow boots. I debated whether to wear my sunglasses that you see here, which I love, or my snow goggles, and thankfully I went with my snow goggles because the sun reflects up off of the snow. You just get better sun protection with goggles than you do with sunglasses because that light can come in here. It's just so much more intense than it is just on a regular day-to-day thing, and so having those goggles really was helpful. I wore my Wandering Switchback ball cap, which I actually forgot on this trip, which is why I'm not wearing it right now. I invested in some Outdoor Research snow gaiters. These were a lifesaver. I am so grateful that I bought them. I tried a couple of different pairs and I wanted to make sure that they fit with my pants and my snow boots on. And I already have trouble with anything that goes over my calves. Everything, I just have monster calves. It's just the way that it goes. But thankfully these ones fit really well and did a really good job of keeping the snow out of things. There's someone over here fishing off of a stand-up paddleboard. This is the second time that I wore my Oboz Bridger snow boots, and I wore them once in the snow with my wife and my stepdaughter, and then this was the second time I had worn them, and they did a good job. They're of course not perfect. My feet did get cold at night when I was not moving around, or in the morning when I was not moving around, but they were really quite comfortable even with how stiff they are, and they did a good job so far. I mean, they kept my feet pretty dry. My feet were wet at the end of the night, but I don't know how much of that is sweat and how much of that is actually water that got in. But as my feet did get cold and sweaty and I would stop moving, my toes would get really cold and hurt like crazy when I got up to try to move and get some circulation back in. So regardless of what footwear you're wearing, keep that in mind. Overall, I would definitely recommend the Bridger boots, at least for someone like me. And I really like that they come in a wide. That's so hard for me to find, is something that comes in a wide, and these ones do. And so I had actually gone up like I typically do and then ordered a wide, and I ended up having to size down because I end up wearing a 10 in a lot of things that don't come in a wide. I wore a 9.5 wide in these and it was perfect. And that's even with those boot socks on. The snowshoes I wore are my TSL Symbioz Elite, and I'm really happy with these, and they were really comfortable with the Bridger boots, much more comfortable than with my Merrell Moabs. I really like that they have a heel lift, which is critical when you're going uphill, and they have good crampons, so really good traction. While I was in camp, I added my Switchback beanie, which of course kept me nice and toasty, and you can get that on my Etsy shop. I've got my hats down in the links in the description. And then I added sealskins, snow, or waterproof gloves, and they're not the warmest thing, but boy, they really made made a difference. I couldn't do things like light a match or a lighter with them, but I could gather snow to put into my pot to melt for water and just kind of wipe off my hands. And they did a really good job. I'm very happy with them. He's going down river. Nice. For going to bed at night, I had purchased some REI midweight base layers that were wool, and they were awesome. Like, so comfortable. I did not get them skin tight. I got them just a little bit loose, and I swear to God, I would lounge in these in around my house. They're just so comfortable, and they did a good job of keeping me warm. I also added my REI fleece pants, which I probably could have done without. I kind of debated it, and honestly, I just got lazy and didn't take them off. I tried several different styles before this trip, and I wanted ones that I could use with my pea style. There was a pair of the North Face that had like a weird seam on the knee, and I was like, that is gonna drive me crazy. I wanted them to have pockets but not interfere with stuff. I'm really happy with the model that I bought, and I'll put the link in the description again. Again, I don't get anything from REI stuff, so I just, these are what I like. I also added some mittens that I've had for years and years and years, and I bought a Katabatic Crestone hood, which I've used a couple of times. It's a down hood, which is wonderful to wear when you are using a quilt and you don't have a hood on like you would with a sleeping bag. And even as a stomach sleeper, I never really use the hood anyway. So I really love having the Crestone hood that can just move with me as I'm moving around at night, going from side to side, etc. I also slept in my Goose Feet Gear down booties, which I always love. And I have some covers for them that I can usually wear if I need to get up to go pee at night or around camp. I couldn't really do that on this trip just because of how much I was post-holing through the snow. But they have ultralight covers, which I wouldn't recommend for necessarily like hanging out all day in, but they're nice for not having to take off your booties when you want to get up at night. Eventually overnight, I added a neoprene balaclava that I've had for a really long time. And this was just, my nose was cold. My face just kept my face much warmer. In the morning, I added my North Face Nepsi jacket, which I love. Even on backpacking trips, even though it's puffy and like really kind of heavy, it keeps me a lot warmer than a lot of those lightweight puffies do. So it's worth it. I also had some REI rain pants that I bought on clearance, and those did a pretty good job for this trip. They're not necessarily like the kind that don't ever wet out, but for what I was doing on this trip, they were fabulous, and I was able to put them on over my fleece pants. Then when it came to the hike out, it was going to be much colder. So on the hike in, it was about 40 degrees and I was going uphill. On the hike out, it was about 15 and I was going downhill. So I needed to be a lot warmer than I had been on the way up. I took off my Nepsi jacket and I put on my Columbia fleece and then my REI rain jacket, which I have worn in the rain, and this is this first season, so I can't really speak to how the longevity is on it, but it's awesome. I also kept putting the hood back on anytime that I was going through the trees where there had been a lot of snow bombs the day before, although on the trek out, it really wasn't warm enough for there to be the snow bombs from the trees. I wore my goggles, my warm switchback hat, my snow gaiters. I put my rain, left my rain pants on over my fleece pants, which in hindsight, I really kind of wish that I had taken off the fleece pants just because it was so much harder to move around with my base layers, my fleece pants, and my rain pants over them. So when I would fall, for example, it was really challenging to get up. I also wish I had taken the time to change back into my boot socks over my sleep socks. I slept in a pair of my normal hiking boot socks, but I wish that I had, again, taken the time to switch into the boot socks, which were thicker and warmer and taller. And I had dried them out overnight in my foot box. So it wasn't even that they were still wet or anything like that. I just frankly didn't take the time to do it. Again, I'll put links down in the description for all of these items, and I welcome any questions that you might have about any of this gear. I know it can be harder to find gear that is for bigger people, and I'm about a 1X, some things I'm a 2X, and so it's nice to know what does work. And I know that that's still an easier size than for a lot of people to find, but this is what's worked for me. And the snowshoes were a large based on my weight with my gear, my pack, my snowshoes, everything. I was probably about 275. So that made a difference for the snowshoes. And I certainly took that into consideration when I was choosing them. If you'd like to support the channel, I do have a Patreon. I'll put that link in the description. And if you'd like to see my trip report, I have that right up here. I'll look forward to seeing you next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.